The brand new macOS Ventura 13.3 was released and Apple again dropped support for an important feature that legacy unsupported Macs rely on. But fortunately, the new OpenCore Legacy Patcher 0.6.2 was also released today. So as usual, a word of warning. When a new macOS version is released, if you have an unsupported Mac, don't install it right away. The same goes for the version 13.3 that was just released because Apple dropped support for legacy Metal GPUs. And that caused a lot of issues to a widespread variants of unsupported Macs. Fortunately, the new OpenCore Legacy Patcher 0.6.2 was also released and they could reactivate these graphic drivers so that the legacy Metal GPUs should work with version 13.3. Also, they added another very important feature. They didn't even mention it on the front page. You have to go into the change notes to see that. Maybe you noticed problems when you installed Ventura and you don't have Wi-Fi drivers yet because you have to install the root patch for the Wi-Fi drivers, that you cannot use the root patch because you needed a KDK, a kernel development kit, to download from Apple's servers. First problem, you don't have Wi-Fi or Ethernet and you cannot download it, so you cannot install Wi-Fi or Ethernet drivers. That is fixed with a new version because the developers of OpenCore Legacy Patcher added an offline part of the KDKs of the Wi-Fi and Ethernet drivers, so you can first root patch your Mac to have Wi-Fi and Ethernet connection and then do the root patch again for the remaining missing drivers. The second problem was that Apple shuts down its servers for downloading the KDK. So the old version that the legacy patcher uses to download the KDKs did not work anymore. So many of you wrote me in the comments, I tried a root patch, but I always get an error message that I cannot download a KDK. These problems should be out of the way right now. One more tip I got from the comments, and thank you so much to the community for giving me so many comments. If you have a USB 3.0 card, expansion card in your Mac Pro like I have, then the root patch detects this card and doesn't install all the required drivers. So you get a problem with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and maybe your keyboard and your mouse. Get rid of all the expansion cards, get rid of all drives, all USB plugs, whatever, get rid of everything. I just have one SSD inside that has Ventura. And after every update, you have to do another root patch because the update breaks the root patch because the root patch is done to macOS itself. OpenCore Legacy Patcher installs on a different partition. It is just a bootloader, so it doesn't change anything on the macOS, but the root patch does, and that is required to get all the drivers into macOS. But there's one more thing that they could integrate, and that is hardware video encoding for AMD GPUs. And that is the RX series, the Vega series, and some more. You should be able now to use DRM content, so digital right management content like Netflix or Disney Plus, on these Macs without any issues. But now let's install macOS Ventura 13.3 and see if it's worth on a Mac Pro. So that looks very promising. I did the update to macOS Ventura 13.3 and then after the update it was so slow, so sluggish because the root patch was missing and the graphic acceleration. The new root patch is applied, you do the reboot, and Wi-Fi is working. I just to make sure I disconnected the Ethernet cable. This is just Wi-Fi connection. Bluetooth is working, so my wireless mouse and keyboard has connection and works. And this is Apple TV. And as you can see, the trailer of Avatar runs here. So the video encoding and decoding functionality of the AMD Radeon RX 580 has been established by the open core patcher. And the best thing is to check this if you go into the video proc converter and you check here for the H264 video compression, and I give you the link to the freeware download down in the video description. And you can do the same check for HEVC, and also here the encoder runs the test and is available up until 4K resolution. As far as I could test macOS Ventura 13.3 here in that short amount of time on my Mac Pro, this looks very promising that this should work, and that you can, that is the first version where you can really work with your Mac Pro on Ventura. By the way, as I removed my USB 3.0 card that I had in the Mac Pro before, in the root patch, it then said USB 1.1 patch and graphics patch is available. This does not show up if you have a USB 3.0 card, so it doesn't see the necessity for the USB 1.1 patch. But now let's test the Mac Pro 2013, if that works as well. And as you can see here, the Mac Pro 2013 also is able to render the trailer of the avatar in Apple TV. So this also looks very promising for the Mac Pro 2013. But in comparison to 2012, where I have upgraded the graphics card, this one still has the old FirePro D300 graphic cards from 2013. And there were three models, D300, 500 and 700, but they're all from 2013. And so they managed to get the video encoding running smoothly, as you can see here on the avatar trailer in Apple TV. But when you switch over to the video proc converter and you go into the options and you test for H264 or HEVC video encoding and decoding, it always says not available. So the solution to this might be an eGPU, an external GPU, where you have an external case with a power supply and you put maybe the RX 580 into that and connect that via a Thunderbolt 2 cable. But that is something that I will test in another video in the Ultimate Mac Pro Guide. So if you haven't yet, I recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notification so you don't miss the guide and any more news and updates about macOS Ventura on unsupported Macs.